What is good, YouTube family? This is your girl Leah. I'm back with another video. Today's Black History fact will be centered around Mary Ellen Pleasant. My apologies for not being consistent with the Black History facts for this month because I know I missed like a good week or two. Well, because I have school. But to digress, today we're going to be talking about Mary Ellen Pleasant. I came across her biography while looking something up on my phone. And apparently Mary Ellen Pleasant, let's look it up here on the computer. Let's go find it out. So Mary Ellen Pleasant was the first Black successful 19th century American entrepreneur. According to her biography, she, you know, dabbled mostly in real estate. Let me see, I'm looking it up right here, right now as we speak, just so I could have some notes. But I found it on, you know, the CNBC website. It says Mary Ellen Pleasant, one of the first Black self-made millionaires. She used a certain trick to build up, you know, her fortune and her empire. And so basically, Mary Ellen Pleasant, she, you know, was born, let's see, because this is kind of in the way, there's an ad on the website or whatever. Okay, I've been looking for it. Okay, cool. So basically, she was born in 1814. Some sources say she was born to slaves. Others say that she was born free in Philadelphia. But, you know, during her childhood, she was separated from her parents and she went to work in Massachusetts as a domestic servant. And from there, you know, she learned how to read and write, you know, basic stuff, arithmetic, whatever. But she didn't get a formal education. And so fast forward to 1852, she worked as a domestic servant and a cook for wealthy businessmen, wealthy white businessmen. And so, you know, during the tenure as, you know, a domestic worker, she managed to, you know, pick up or to gain some knowledge, you know, about investing tips given by her employers, you know, or conversations between her employers. And, you know, according to her 2003 biography, The Making of a Mammy, the author, Lynn Hudson, said it was possible for her to, it was possible that the jobs that she used was a ploy to, you know, make money from her investments. And so while she, you know, was a cook, she earned about, oops, there's a video, hold on. Anyway. I digress. So apparently as a domestic, she earned about $500 a month and she invested her salary into her savings. Well, she invested her savings into real estate and then eventually gold mines because at the time the gold rush was occurring. And so basically it says here throughout the 1850s and 60s, she bought all kinds of businesses from like laundry to boarding houses. But you know, being that she was Black, she kind of had to disguise herself as a domestic worker. And then at one point, you know, during her, I guess, career, she met this bank clerk, named Thomas Bell, who wanted to, you know, forge a business partnership with her. And, you know, to avoid discrimination, according to the New York Times, she had to, you know, put most of her investments under Bell's name because he was white and she was Black, and it was unheard of for a Black woman to, you know, make investments by herself. And so they bought together, you know, under their partnership. Bell and Pleasant bought all kinds of shares, from laundries to dairies to restaurants and Wells Fargo Bank, which I'm a proud banker, or not proud banker, but a proud customer of. And with their combined fortune, it estimated to about more than $30 million, which would be about $864 today based on inflation, according to this website that I'm looking at. And, you know, throughout her life, she lived with Bill and his family, you know, in their mansion, this big old 985-acre ranch in Sonoma Valley, northeast of San Francisco. But throughout her life, you know, she had to deal with all kinds of rumors that she was with Bill as his mistress, and that, you know, there were claims, false claims, that she was practicing witchcraft and voodoo. And, you know, throughout her life, she supported, like, you know, she was abolitionist as well, because she supported, you know, she was against slavery. She even worked on the Underground Railroad, too, to help, you know, enslaved African Americans become free. And then, you know, she married twice. One of her husbands was a mixed race merchant and abolitionist who tragically passed but left her a very huge inheritance. And then, according to this website, it says here that you know, while she was helping, you know, enslaved African Americans, you know, transport themselves on the Underground Railroad, she also helped them, you know, find jobs and housing. And then, you know, her wealth continued to grow, and, you know, she continued to involve herself in civil rights. And she's also even recognized as the mother of the civil rights movement in California, because she had a case where she sued two streetcar companies for, you know, racial prejudice or racial discrimination. And as a result, her cases and other, I guess, early cases kind of paved the way for desegregation on streetcars and eventually later down the line facilities. And so she invested a lot in the anti-slavery efforts as well. She sent about over $30,000 to fund John Brown's 1859 raid on Harper's Ferry, you know, to an attempt to basically create a slave revolt in the southern United States that went wrong. Unfortunately, her wealth ran out, and, you know, after Bell had passed in 1892, his widow had sued Pleasant, you know, for controlling their multi-million dollar fortune. And eventually she died broke and in poverty. Another thing was, what caused her to, you know, lose her wealth as well was that, a lot of her finances were tightly associated with Bell, so it's kind of difficult to determine which ones was her own. And as a result, you know, the rumors about the voodoo and witchcraft, you know, kept coming, and, you know, her reputation was basically diminished, and she was evicted from her mansion. And even though she showed evidence that she designed the building and paid for the construction, and so until she had passed away at almost 90 years old, she had to live with friends, and she died in poverty in 1904. And that's a sad, unfortunate end, but I find it quite courageous, and I find it quite admiring that, you know, a woman in the 19th century, a Black woman nonetheless, had the audacity and even the courage to, you know, create a fortune and to, you know, make wealth and learn and educate herself about, you know, financial investment, because as a Black community, we are probably one of the largest, we represent the largest, you know, percentage of consumers, at least in America. I can't speak for the rest of my people across the diaspora, but we represent a larger percentage of consumers in America. We're like one of the most popular consumers. We consume everything, and as a result, our wealth goes to pot. It diminishes because we're constantly buying stuff that, you know, is really of no value. And it kind of looking at the story kind of teaches me the importance of, you know, being financially literate, because I know one thing, it's important, you know, to create generational wealth, some wealth you can pass to your children once you're gone. It's kind of something that I want to do at some point. And I also want to try to invest in stock and maybe try to budget more, because I know I have a tendency to be a compulsive buyer, let's say that. I used to call it a spendthrift, but I don't think that's the right term, but I can be a compulsive buyer. I'll buy something just because I have the means to. But in this day and age, money goes fast, and so what I'm trying to do right now personally is to make like a budget so I could kind of like control my finances and kind of prioritize what I need to buy versus what I want to buy. So this is a very interesting story, you know, about Mary Ellen Pleasant, and I hope it inspires you. And that's gonna be it for today. I'm hoping and I'm guessing that I put out more videos before the end of this month is up, because Black History Month just flew by. And next month is Women's Month, and Women's History Month is my birthday as well. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up, like, share it if you must, and stay tuned for more Black History Facts.